Welcome everybody, welcome back to Head Showered Shaved. My name's James and this is my next video. I hope you guys enjoy it. I was thinking about what kind of topic I was going to follow in this particular shave, and it kind of dawned on me, and it's something that I've spoken about, not spending the earth to enjoy traditional shaving, but I thought it would be nice just to show you how enjoyable a shave can actually be on a budget. There's lots of amazing products out there that you can spend all sorts of money on, and it's a, you know, if you pick it up like as a hobby like I have, then you know it's really enjoyable, as you would have seen. But you don't have to do that. You can just keep it nice and cost effective, and as an alternative to normal modern day razors and products, and you know, save a lot of money in the long run, but still enjoy a fantastic traditional process and enjoy what is wonderful products that make you feel good and make you smell good and ultimately make you look good too. So I thought, how do I go about this? What should I do? And then it just became really obvious. Some of the eagle-eyed out there and that, you know, subscribe to the channel will see that my beard's a little bit shorter this time. I get it trimmed every now and then. It does get a little bit bushy, mainly because the girl prefers it, to be honest. But yeah, I need a bit of a neaten up every now and then. And I went to a Turkish barber's, and certainly here in the UK and over in Ireland as well, where I often find myself. If you want to look for, you know, something akin to a traditional shave now, out and about on the high street, then the Turkish barber's absolutely the place to go. These guys have been doing it for years and years and years. They know what they're doing. Really, really good pricing, and you get a really great experience. So I thought, you know what? I'm going to focus on a Turkish brand. And that Turkish brand is called Arko, spelled A-R-K-O. Now, this is that brand. They are a Turkish-based firm, and they have a whole host of products within their range. Just have a, if you've got an Amazon account, just go onto your Amazon account and type in Arko, and just have a look at the length and breadth of products that they sell. And you'll see a lot of choice. And what you'll also see is that from a cost perspective, it's absolutely unbelievable value. So you do a whole host of stuff. So what we're going to use today is an Arko soap, and forgive me, I haven't got the full packaging to show you here, but this is a very classic Arko based soap. We're going to be using that. In terms of cost, well, you can get that, and I'm not kidding, you can get a box of six for about £6, including delivery. And I kid you not, a box of six of those, that'd last you years. So that's the soap covered. Pennies, great product, lasts forever. That's the soap. In terms of the aftershave itself, the first thing that really struck me, and probably strikes you, that looks a little bit like a shower gel. Don't let it fool you. Yes, it's plastic. Yes, it looks like a shower gel, but it's not. It is an aftershave cologne. Now, this product is better than the product packaging suggests. It's brilliant. It comes in a nice big volume, 250 milliliters. This on Amazon again, research it, test it. It's absolute pennies again. They normally come in packs of 2, 3, or 6, but like, you are talking, you know, for a tenner, you can get a number of these bottles, and they last ages, and they smell absolutely fantastic. I've got a few types. This is another one here. This particular one here is the Gold Power. And this one here is the Black Edition. Again, that looks a little bit like Lynx, doesn't it? But no, this is an aftershave. And I tell you what, it's a fantastic product. But you're talking pennies. You know, if you work out the cost of a traditional shave and project it out, I mean, it's next to nothing. Really, really good products. There's all sorts of additional other products that you can get as well. There's like different types of aftershave creams, and there's all types of different lotions and different things. Honestly, this is all about Arco, and this is about cost-effective head shaving, where you can still have an amazing experience and it doesn't cost the earth. Absolutely brilliant. What more could you want? So in the spirit of this, we're going to use a very, very, well, we're going to use the first razor that I ever vlogged on, which is the Mercor 28C. Now this, I have got a whole vlog on this one, so just very loosely, this is the best switch over traditional double-edged razor that you can go to if you're used to just the traditional modern Gillette style razors, because it's got a slightly longer handle and it's a little bit closer in form to what you're used to. A lot of the razors that we use are a lot shorter in handle because you've got to be a lot lighter on your touch, and I won't go any more than that. We know all about that. But this is a really good switch over. But this was really inexpensive. Now this is solid metal. This is going to last for your whole lifetime. And I think that cost me about £24. And inside it, I've just got a shark blade, which I've spoken about many times on the vlogs. And I bought like 100 of those for like £10 online, which is like just unbelievable. So once you start bringing it all together and you're looking at a really good razor like this, you know, nice, effective, sharp blade, and then you look at the types of products, and it doesn't cost much at all to set you up. It doesn't have to cost the earth to look good, feel good, and smell good. As good a value as anything I've just shown you is the Omega brushes. Now, I've shown you these before, but this particular one is just a normal boar brush, Omega shaving brush, and this cost me, I think, about £8 online, and it is unbelievably good. In terms of performance, it doesn't fall short in any way, shape or form. So akin to what we've looked at here, a really cost-effective product and a demonstration that it doesn't have to cost the earth to have an amazing shave. Right, I'm going to get things ready now and then we're going to enjoy the shave. Okay, let's go. Right, here's my soap. Now this is a solid bar, and what I like to do with a solid bar is I like to apply it directly onto the stubble on my head. I find that I get a really, really good coverage all over the skin, and it helps me to work it inwards, and it delivers an absolutely faultless lather when I come at it with the brush. So what I'm just gonna do is I'm just gonna dip it in a little bit of warm water just to soften that soap. And it just helps you apply it to the stubble, just like this. There we go, just rubbing it on, nice and easy. And you can't really see it as you build it up, but it's getting on there, I assure you. You'll see when I come to apply the brush and start lathering it. But here we go, get it into all the little places. And this really helps put down a good bed of soap. This helps get rid of all your dead skin because you're having a good little rub and rummage around. This is absolutely a really brilliant way. It doesn't look pretty, I know, but it's a really, really good way of making sure that you just get right in there and get an excellent coverage of soap ready to lather. Right, that'll do. Let's see how much lather we get from that. Okay, here we are with a brush. Let's give it a go. See, you can start to see it building already. Look at that. See, it's there. It's working. Just need a bit more moisture. There we are. That's the thing with soap, it really needs that water to unlock itself. Look at that, unbelievable. It just takes off. You get the right amount of water and it just explodes. And you get that lovely lava that produces the protection and helps the hairs floats upwards into the actual thickness of the lava, so that as the blade comes in, it's not trying to cut a hair that is laying flat against the skin, it's suspended in the soap. So that's what a good lava is all about. A little bit more water. There we are, but got to be a bit careful here. Once you get it on and do a couple of swirls, you tend to find that's it. It thickens a bit now with the other soap. So look at that, absolutely brilliant. Really, really nice lava. And I tell you what, this boar brush is fantastic. I call it scritchy. I don't even know if scritchy's a word, but I tell you what, it seems to fit what it does. It scratches away at my skin, which I love. Now, it's not uncomfortable. It's perfectly soft and nice, but it just makes sure that I give that exfoliating experience on my skin, which A, helps for a much nicer, closer shave, but also, you know, it's a bit more hygienic and gives a better finish. So I think that'll do. Absolutely brilliant. Look at that. Brilliant. All I've done is I've got the soap, I've rubbed it all around my head, got a bit of water, bosh. Away we go. Happy days. Cool, there we go. I've just picked this out, the sink full of warm water. Never run a cold piece of metal over your skin in terms of a blade. Just don't do it. Always make sure it's nice and warm. Right, let's go. First pass with the grain. I tell you, one thing I will say is that the confidence levels I've got in this particular razor is just off the scale. It is a mild razor, so, you know, it's not going to perform to incredible levels. But I tell you what, it's absolutely more than good enough. It's currently Wednesday evening, and for a Wednesday evening midweek shave, this is absolutely no problem at all. And I can really throw myself into this shave because I just know that it's a brilliant, brilliant razor that just isn't going to cause me any harm or any grief, but it still gives me a lovely finish. There we go, pass one. Absolutely brilliant job, fantastic. Right, let's get on with another layer of soap. Need a bit more water. Just bring that soap alive, nice and slow on the water, and then it will take. There we are, perfect. And then bosh, it's amazing how much life you get out of soap with a bit more water. You think it's all gone, but it's kind of dried up, and you can reinvigorate it and you can bring it back to life. Now, the first application of soap, as we know, is the most important. So we don't need to concentrate just as much on the next application. Okay, pass number two, across the grain. that's pass number two. I tell you what, really, really good job. Absolutely perfect. Right. Tiny bit more water again. Off we go. Still some left if I needed it. Unbelievable. Brilliant. Pass number three against the grain. Right, that's the end of pass number three. How simple and easy and enjoyable was that? I mean, I rant and rave on here. You guys have seen me. I go nuts at some of the products. But I tell you what, there's a place for a shave that isn't using any of your real premium products, but it's just using a nice, cost-effective product. That is still wonderful. I mean, what a love. I mean, that is an absolute banging shave. Absolutely brilliant on a Wednesday night for pennies. I tell you, you can't beat it. You don't have to spin the earth. I cannot stress that enough. Check out the brand Arco. You'll get some absolute bargains. Right, okay. Aftershave wise, I've got a choice of two, because as I showed you earlier, I've got two. I've got the Gold Power, or I've got the Black Edition. And I'm going to go for Gold Power. And there's a reason for that. Now, because this is just like a shower gel style bottle, which I'm not judging, that's absolutely fine. It's very easy to just tip and apply. Oh, I'll tell you what, that sting and that coolness and that wave of beautiful sensation is here. That lovely, oh my goodness. And I'll tell you, the smell is much, 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 much better than you might think. This particular one, the Gold Power, is well renowned for being a really close match to Paco Rabanne 1 million. You know, that one, the funny advert. Whew, that 1 million looks like a gold bullion bar. Well, this is a very, very close match. And I don't mean like a rubbish match, I mean a good one. Now, it's really strong. Like, I've put it on and it's filled my bathroom with a wonderful smell, but it fades lovely. And what I find, because it's like an aftershave that's like focused on also being a cologne, that it lasts a much longer than a normal aftershave would. So 2 or 3 hours after I've had a head shave, I sit there and I rub my head and I smell my hand and it's still there. It's still giving off a lovely aroma. So it lasts for ages. I can't speak about it highly enough, but check it out. But yeah, pretty simple one here from me today. That's it. I hope you guys have enjoyed it. Just gives you food for thought on the alternative products that are out there. And if anyone knows a thing or two about traditional shaving, then it's the Turkish. So yeah, get on that Arco. I highly recommend it. So if you're starting to think about maybe shaving your head and you're going bald and you're not knowing, you know, you don't want to take the plunge, don't even delay. Get it done. I tell you, it's the best thing I've ever done. I started to go bald and I thought, you know what? I'm going to let it go. I'm going to shave my head and see what it feels like. And I have not looked back since. The sensation I get, how I feel, this process I go through gives me that little window of well-being where all I'm thinking about is what I'm doing. I'm not thinking about work or anything like that. It's absolutely wonderful, so get on it. But I have to say, thank you very much to a couple of the new subscribers that have subscribed this week. I really appreciate it. Thank you very much to all my regular viewers. I love you guys. My numbers are going up and I feel absolutely brilliant. And I've got to do a big hi to my mate Dag, who always gives a comment on my videos, whether they're rubbish or not. He's a very kind guy. I love him to death. So this is a big shout out to Dag. Anyways, I'll leave it there. This is James Howard of Head Showered Shaved. I've really enjoyed it. And I'll see you guys soon. Take care.